grew up feeling that I had a pretty good understanding of the military lifestyle. Those that are impacted, as we talk about military, it's not just the parent that's serving, but also the kids that are involved, the kids that are moving every 2 to 3 years, which does create an opportunity for those working in the real estate industry. Many, especially in the Navy, are given orders, PCSing. They PCS every 2 to 3 years and are given orders that they have to move. So if they purchased here, there's a great chance that 3 years from now, they're going to have to sell that property. And if you've properly served them and you've given them some of the tips that we're going to jump into here shortly, of what it is, what's important to know when representing somebody who's in the military, especially a retired military, you know, when we're going to talk in regards to the funding fee, it's a huge opportunity to then represent them 2 to 3 years later if they get PCS'd across the country, as well as knowing the challenges and the stresses of what they're going through as they come to try to relocate to our area. Usually they have a short window of time that they need to see a massive amount of properties, learn a completely new area, jumping from a very low price point typically of where they're coming from to a very high price point here that's over $500,000 in many situations for entry level. So you can imagine the amount of pressure that is on the military member as they make this move, and then the family dynamics, the kids that are in high school that have created their identities, their friends, they're leaving all that and they're moving to a completely unknown area. I remember we heard as we came from Andrews Air Force Base, you don't want to go to that school. That's a gang infested school there. And, you know, I mean, we could have easily tried to do private school or another option, but we just came from Thurgood Marshall Middle School and Oxon Hill High School, walking through metal detectors. So I was up for the challenge, to say the least. But after I went to the school, saw that, you know, there were a couple gangs, they messed with each other, but they didn't mess with anybody else. And it was an awesome experience where I actually met my wife and have this beautiful family today because of not following the misinformation that's out there. So that's some of what I wanted to touch on. And anything you'd like to add to that, Deb?
No, I think that's a valid concern. If anybody who's watching this has been subjected to a move, you know what that involves: a lot of stress, a lot of anxiety, a lot of planning, coordination, communicating with all the people involved, movers, packers, utilities, mailmen, all that kind of stuff. We'll throw in the factor of a cross-country move, you know, from East Coast to West Coast, throw in a move from Hawaii or Okinawa, Japan. You can imagine some of the intangibles involved with that. So these are the kind of things to be empathetic and hopefully supportive of when you deal with these clients, understanding why they may come in a little bit tired, a little bit, I wouldn't say short fused, but they're kind of pre-wired. You also have a PTSD issue that you may be subjected to. Now, I can take that whole conversation a couple different directions, and I don't see, and I deal with a lot of veterans, a lot of active duty, I don't see it on display as much, thank God, as what could be. One of my capacities, I didn't go into too much of my background, but when we closed down our first company, Paradise Estates, in 2008, because of my education and my background, I went to the base and I was the financial educator for both Port Hueneme and Point Magoo. And what that entailed was I was the gentleman who was tasked with trying to save a lot of careers because they were based on security clearances. And the security clearances were in jeopardy at that time because of short sales and foreclosures. That was, you know, pandemic to that time and the housing needs. And again, with the military folks, if they couldn't make these bills, and again, if you've been doing this for a while and you know what the interest-only loan was all about, or these adjustable rate mortgages, a lot of people had to basically strategically default on their loans. And for the civilian sector, it's bad enough having your credit hit. The military sector, it's credit plus security clearance. Well, keep in mind, the security clearance will cost them their job, which means they'll throw them out of the service. So we had a whole different set of pressures. And in my capacity, about 6 years, while I got my broker's license, did a little bit of consultancy unofficially on the side, helping people out. I got a good feel for some of their anxiety, some of their concerns. And the reason I decided to get back into this, and instead of looking at, reviving Paradise Estates, I definitely grew an entire new affinity for the military folks. And that's why, the purpose behind Veteran Home Services was spawned because of some of these concerns in these areas that we need to help out our sailors and soldiers and airmen. There's a definite product there for everybody. Again, you don't have to be a veteran like myself. I think what would behoove you and the clients is to try and understand what they're going through, okay, as much as you can, i.e. the MRP. I also did another certification a couple years ago, FTBS, First Time Buyers Specialist. It's another great certification to get if you want to work with buyers and first timers. And what I appreciated about it was the demographic challenges in terms of age discrimination. And, the boomers are going and the millennials and Zs and everybody else are coming along. I'm old school. I know enough to know what I don't know. And that first-time home buyer certification, first-time buyer certification specialist, so to speak, kind of enlightened me on some of the challenges that the younger generation are going through. So it was a nice combination of putting my military background with this new certification. So I'd highly recommend, while folks are staying home for their continued education, to consider an MRP or a FTBS. Those are just things that'll take you in a whole another direction when we're ready to get back to work, which we'll talk about in a second.